welcome inside fitnessinformant.com, Fitness Informant's YouTube channel. I'm FI founder and CEO Ryan Buck. I want to thank you for stopping by to check out our 100% honest, no bullshit review of Rice Supplements Loaded Protein. This one is going to be the Cinnamon Toast one that we're going to review today based on five different categories. The first, we're going to look at the ingredient profile on this loaded protein. Second, we're going to talk about effectiveness. Third, we're going to talk about flavor. Fourth, we're going to talk about mixability, as well as show you a mixability test here on camera. And then finally, we're going to talk about value on this product. So let's dive into the ingredient profile on this. Essentially, for your macros, you have 120 calories, 2 grams of fat, 3 grams of carbohydrates with 1 dietary fiber, so you have 2 grams of net carbs, and you're also going to get 24 grams of protein. The protein sources come from two variations. The first is going to be your whey protein isolate, and the second is going to be whey protein concentrate. So those of you who have watched this channel for a while and been following us know that whey protein isolate is a minimum of 90% quality. Whey protein concentrate can be anywhere from 34% to 80%. So that's one call out here that I wish Rice would call out on their label, is what quality of whey protein concentrate is being used in this actual powder. Not to say that they're going low, but there have been companies in the past that have done whey protein isolate as ingredient number one, and then they use a cheap filler whey protein concentrate for number two. I will tell you, based on effectiveness and lack of bloat or weird digestion issues, I don't believe that this is a low quality whey protein concentrate, but that is just for you guys to know. There are a couple of added things in here too. They do include MCT oil as well, 1 gram. They also include 1 gram of organic prebiotic fiber to help with digestion. These are things that you see more and more as it comes to protein powders. It's not just your whey protein powder. It's not just, you know, a clean label. They're adding different things like prohydrolase and velocitol and certain ingredients that can help amino acid uptake and increase muscle protein synthesis. You don't find any of those unique ingredients in here, but you do find, like I said, that gram of prebiotic fiber and the gram of MCTs. Essentially, each serving size is about 33.6 grams, and of that, 24 grams is protein. So that can really, that's an equation that you can do at home. You always take the protein powder amount, the 24 grams, divided by 33.6. That tells you how much protein per scoop you're getting. The higher the number, closer to 100, the cleaner the protein is going to be. Basically, that means that protein is going to be more protein versus some of the other stuff like fillers and flavoring systems. So overall, this is a pretty standard profile. It's very similar to some of the ones on the market today that you see WPI and WPC. I would like to see WPC called out in terms of quality, and I can actually reach out to the company as well to find that out. But overall, a decent profile, nothing wrong with it. A dual blend of protein, the whey protein isolate for the faster absorption and faster digestion, and then the whey protein concentrate, which is just a little bit slower than whey protein isolate. In terms of effectiveness, I kind of alluded to this before, you don't get the muscle or the stomach bloat, you don't get digestive issues like you do with some proteins. Typically, when you get that in a protein powder, it's going to be on the cheaper end of the protein powder spectrum, meaning that you're probably getting a WPC-34, because WPC-34 has a ton of lactose in it, and as human beings, we're not necessarily set up to digest lactose, because our body produces less and less lactase as we get older, so that's some of the digestive issues that you get. You don't feel, like I said, you don't feel bloated, it goes down smooth, there's no issues with that, you don't feel heavy per se after having this protein from Rice. So overall, I'd say it's hard to judge effectiveness of a protein powder. It really is an extension of the profile. Based on this profile being a standard to good profile, it's going to be a standard to good effectiveness on the protein powder as well. In terms of flavor, this one is going to be Cinnamon Toast. And I'll say this, like, I've had cinnamon cereal, cinnamon flavored protein powders before. This is by far my favorite cinnamon flavored protein powder that I've had. I think Rice did a phenomenal job on their flavoring system. It tastes like the milk of Cinnamon Toast Crunch after you drink it, or if you have done that before. It tastes very similar to that, very smooth. It's not overly cinnamony. It's not overly toasty, I guess you could say. To me, it was perfect. There's a perfect balance of the two. It tasted great. It'd be something that's good to add to coffee as well. No issues there. In terms of mixability on this, like I mentioned, each serving size is 33.6. So we're going to show you here on camera that we're going to do one scoop of this actually in a shaker cup to 16 ounces of water per the instructions. It mixes really well, which means obviously with whey protein isolate being ingredient number one, that actually is going to mix better than any concentrate. But the combination of the two does mix really well. No clumps at all. Like, you might have minute little tiny pieces, but like nothing crazy. It really depends on what type of shaker bottle that you use as well. And as you can see here in the video, that we used a blender bottle to blend this up. Overall, very pleased with the mixability on this, as well as the taste. And in terms of value, this is a 2-pound tub. It does retail for $40. That's really in line for what you expect. So typically a 2 pound tub will retail for $40 if it's a straight whey protein isolate. So this might be a little bit on the higher end of price. A 2 pound tub of a whey protein concentrate is gonna be a little bit lower, but because this is a blend, I could see $35 to $40 being an actual price that is fair for this product. So that is definitely a product worth it. I mean, the taste alone is something cool and unique and different than a lot of the protein powders that are on the market today. So for $40 for 2 pounds, that is basically gonna be $20 a pound, which is kind of the going rate for protein powders, I think is fair. It's nothing crazy, nothing out of the ordinary. Check below for your coupon code. We might have a coupon code to save you a few dollars on this product as well, which will make this even more valuable. But I would recommend isolated protein. I think it tastes good. I think it's great. I think like I said, I'll reach out and try to get some more clarification on the WPC, but based on my personal feelings on it, my personal effectiveness from it, didn't feel bloated, didn't feel weird, so I think it's probably a decent quality. Again, if you want to purchase this product, we'll include a purchase link here below in the description. Check below for a coupon code as well. Make sure you're following us on all our social media channels. We're on Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, and Twitter. Subscribe to our YouTube channel by clicking on the red subscribe now button here below to stay up to date with all the new rice supplement reviews, rankings, more protein powder reviews, and more. We have a podcast. It's called Be Informed, Live Fit. You can get that on iTunes, Spotify, Google Podcasts, Stitcher, and right here on YouTube. Make sure you subscribe to that to hear great interviews with people like Jay Cutler, Ronnie Coleman, Branch Warren, and Ashley Horner. And for this full in-depth written review, more reviews, rankings, deals, news, fitness routines, and nutrition plans, check us out online. We're at fitnessinformant.com.